Good afternoon, Vinyl Community. How y'all doing? It's same day. I just did a second video on the same day. And it is still January 3rd, 2022. Happy New Year to you all. This is my Vinyl Tag 2022. This is my Vinyl Tag 2022. I've never done a Vinyl Tag before because my channel really just got started last April. So here is my first one, and this is the Rob Walker one. I think there's two of them out there or something like that, but I saw Ron Haggerty do his, and it was based on the Rob Walker 2022 with 22 questions. Not really questions, of course. They're just show an album like this, show an album like that, show this, show that, blah, blah, blah. So here I go. I'm going to try to do this quickly because there are 22 to get through. Hang on a second. I'm just going to... Well, I'll actually pick them up off the ground. They're just below my feet here. Anyways, so what's the first one? We got number one, favorite album purchased in 2021. All right, well, it doesn't have to be, you know, released in 2021. It doesn't have to be, it's just, what's your favorite pickup? So I'm going to go with McCoy Tyner. Tender Moments. This was originally released in September of 1968. This is the Tone Poet. On Blue Note, it's just an absolute incredible record. It's unbelievable sounding as well. What do we got? We got Lee Morgan on trumpet. And, I can't see that. Herbie Lewis on bass, Joe Chambers on drums. Just an incredible piece of work. I love this record. I've been spinning it over and over again. And, of course, the Tone Poet series is just... Well, it's a they're beautiful, and the jacket, I'm not going to take them all out or anything. The jacket is just the crisp and beautiful, and the photographs inside are unreal, but this is my favorite pickup from last year, Tender Moments, McCoy Tyner. All right. Second question. Album by the first person or band you ever saw live. Well, I've shown it before, and I'll show it again. Rush Moving Pictures was the very first show I ever saw. The album was released in February 1981, and this is, this is a original copy. I went to see Rush live in Toronto, Maple Leaf Gardens, in March of 1981, and it was a month after they released the record I saw them. Absolutely stellar Rush record. Always has been, always will be. So this is the band I saw for the very first time. Rush Moving Pictures Tour. Okay, the next question. Album by a duo. Oh, okay. Well, you know, I've been collecting. I've been seeing a lot of these lately. So this is Hall & Oates, Beauty on a Backstreet. This was released in September of 1977. I've been having a lot of luck finding Hall & Oates records, and this is a great one. Well, it's not a great one, but it's a good one, and it's one of those, it's one of those records that is kind of forgotten about, and but it's a good record. I like it. I've really enjoyed listening. I've only listened to it once, but I'll spin it again. I actually bought another one of these, not realizing I'd already bought this one. Anyway. Here's the duo entry, Hall & Oates, Beauty on a Backstreet from 77. All right. Album Still in the Shrink. Oh, yeah. Okay. I picked this up not too long ago. Charles Me, you can see there. It cost me $25. It's a 1986 U.S. pressing. Charles Mingus, Black Saint, and Sinner Lady, and you can see... Still in the Shrink, the original Shrink from 86. Now, obviously, this is a reissue. This is not, from 1986, and it's not the original cover. The original cover was different, too. So this 86 Impulse, MCA Impulse reissue is a different cover altogether. But it's a great record, and I'm glad I picked this up. $25, I think it's a pretty good deal for something from an 86, and it's in great mint shape. All right. Put that down there. All right, Still in the Shrink. So now we're onto a concept record. Oh, yeah. So it's kind of two records in one. Frank Zappa's Joe's Garage, Act 1. Frank Zappa's Joe's Garage Act 2 and 3. I'm a big Zappa fan, and the concept, I mean, it's a great concept. Joe, the kid Joe from LA, and the central scrutinizer, the government spokesperson, narrates the whole thing, and it's just a record about, yeah, it's political, it's a lot of, it's got a lot of sexual, and Joe's, this kid's upbringing in Los Angeles and his life at that time. It's a great, great series of records, and yeah, it was released September and November of 79, so this one September of 79, and this one in November of 79. Fantastic record. I believe it's on the, yeah, the Zappa, it's on the Zappa label. And there you go, there's my concept records for that question. Okay, what do we have next? Show an album you've not played yet. Well, here we go. Prince, Love Sexy. I found this record recently. Fabulous, amazing find. Got it for $5, if you can believe that. Now, this one I will show. $5, a friend. I've got a lot of records. I wanted to do a whole update on it. But you can't find Prince records for anything like in this kind of condition for anything less than, you know, $20, $25. There's the original insert. It's just fantastic. It's so glad to have found it, but I have not played it yet because I have not cleaned it and I have not cataloged it and cleaned it and done all the right things. So I haven't spun this yet, but I just got it a couple of months ago. All right, an artist you've discovered in 2021. Okay, a little backstory to this. It's not an artist I have heard of him, but, and you know, anyway, Julian Cope. I had never listened to Julian Cope. And really, it was due to Hannah, the Omaha introvert, that is a big Teardrop Explodes fan. And I knew of Teardrop Explodes back in the day, but I hadn't listened to them. So she had talked about Teardrop and Julian Cope. And I figured I'd give it a shot. I got this in early 2021. St. Julian, yeah, great record. This was March of 1987, I believe this was released, and so yeah, here's an artist. I you know, again, I knew the name, I knew nothing about the music, so that's my discovery, is Julian Cope's solo work, and thanks to Hannah, the Omaha introvert, for putting me on to Julian Cope. All right, next question. A live album. All right, well, here's another fabulous live record, Bill Withers Live at Carnegie Hall. This is a Music on Vinyl reissue. This was originally put out in April of 73, but of course, like I just said, this is the reissue for this record. Fantastic live record. World Keeps Going Around. It starts off side two. It's just phenomenal. What a great version. But yeah, I love this live record. Glad I picked it up in the reissue. What a pressing. It's beautiful pressing. Beautiful packaging, the whole thing. Glad I grabbed this.
All right, let me just straighten up down here.
Okay. Album from a different continent. Well, I did do some digging, but I couldn't really find anything, I from any other continent but Europe, really, so... Radiohead, OK Computer, fabulous. When was this originally put out? I guess it was 97. Love this record, love Radiohead. So I'm not gonna, don't need to talk too much about this. Everyone knows OK Computer, and what an outstanding, I mean, the 90s for Radiohead was just amazing. And this record was just a stellar piece of work. All right. Next one is an album with a picture with the price sticker still on the jacket. All right, Johnny Cash at Folsom Prison. If I can bring that in there. I think it's 429, not 430, not 450, but 429. And amazing, this is another one that's still in the shrink. You can see that. It's kind of, you know, coming up there, but I got this years and years ago, and It's an original Canadian pressing of 2i Columbia right there. Very happy to have found this, and that there's that price sticker on it. Where is it called? Save-At. It's called some place called Save-At. Johnny Cash at Folsom Prison. Okay. The next one. Punk or New Wave album. All right, well, I decided to go with Echo and the Bunnymen, Porcupine. Good New Wave record, Echo and the Bunnymen, from 83, February. This was also part of that same record collection I got from a buddy, bought $5 each, and he was getting rid of some stuff, and I grabbed 36 records off of him for $5 a piece. Amazing. He was just, what an amazing opportunity I was able to have. So anyway, this is my New Wave, Echo and the Bunnymen, Porcupine from 1983. Good record. Not considered one of their best records, but it's a bit of a darker record, but I dig it. It's a good record. All right. Okay, the next one is Show a Box Set. I don't have a lot of box sets, but here's one I picked up in 2020, which is, hang on a second, records are falling. Black Crowes, 30th anniversary, Shake Your Moneymaker. Not going to take it all out, but yeah, it's great. They've, you know, the original album re-released. Then there's unreleased songs and B-sides here, side B of that, and then the fantastic The Homecoming Concerts, Atlanta, Georgia, December 1990. All the live, there's a live record that's just fantastic, so... This is the 30th anniversary of the Black Crowes, Shake Your Moneymaker. Great box set.
All right.
Now, this one might be a tiny bit, I don't think it's a stretch really. Album with a sporting theme. I went with the Birds, Sweetheart at the Rodeo. I couldn't find anything. I was looking and looking, but you know, you got some tying up. You gotta tie up the bull there. You got trick riding down here. You've got some bull riding over here, some roping up here. Rodeo is a sport, isn't it? I think it is. I'm going with the rodeo. The Birds, Sweetheart of the Rodeo, for my option for an album with a sporting theme. Great record. I know it's been shown 1,000 times in the VC, but it's something I went with on this. All right, now I'll show a jazz album. Well, I've already done that, but I'm gonna show another one. One of my favorite records by Miles Davis. Miles Smiles from February of 1967. An outstanding record, and it's an OG Canadian. There's the 2i Columbia. It is one of my all-time favorites, favorite Miles records. It's just incredible. There isn't a bad track on it. Orbit, Circle, Footprints, Dolores, Freedom, Jazz, Dance, and Gingerbread Boy. Incredible. Wayne Shorter, Herbie Hancock, Ron Carter, and Tony Williams on drums. Just an incredible lineup. Whoops. Hit the, there we go. Anyway, you've seen that. This is my jazz album. Okay, Vinyl Tag 2022. What do we got next? Oh, yes. A best of album. Shown this in the past as well, but The Stones, Through the Past Darkly, Big Hits Volume 2. There's an original UK pressing. There's the Decca label. I have actually not spun this one. I don't know why. It's in such great shape, and I don't even know. I have another copy. I have the Canadian version, which is not the cutout, octagon or anything like that. So I don't know what it is. I'm having a hard time putting it on the turntable for some strange reason. But anyway, this is my entry for the best of, or basically a compilation. One of the many Stones compilations. Okay. What do we have next? Where are we headed? Oh yeah, this was an interesting question. An album with at least 8 people on the jacket. I had to really dig, and then I thought of this one. Max Webster, Canadian band, phenomenal. I've always loved them. Max Webster's Live Magnetic Air. I know it's artwork, and it's, There's the band, 1, 2, 3, 4 band members, and then fans, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So you got at least 11 people represented there live. It was supposed to be, I don't know what club they were in here, but this is a Toronto rock and roll band from the 70s who we all loved and loved them dearly. Rush were big friends of theirs. And so anyone who lived in Southern Ontario, Canada for that matter, but Southern Ontario particularly loved this band. They were huge. All right, that was Max Mercer, Live Magnetic Air. Where are we headed now? Oh yeah, soundtrack. So the next one is a soundtrack, and that this is question, well, where are we at? Number 17 of 22. I don't have a lot of soundtracks, and I've shown this before for the same question. I don't know if I have any other soundtracks than Manhattan. I haven't collected soundtracks. But anyway, so by George Gershwin, phenomenal film, phenomenal soundtrack. And this was, well, the movie was released in April of 79. I'm not exactly sure when this soundtrack would have been released, but probably shortly after that, if not the same month or just after. But anyway, there's my entry for a soundtrack, Manhattan, Woody Allen film.
All right. Question number 18, and I'm hoping this passes for this. So, oh wait, sorry. Yeah, question number 18 is show some VCLT.
Well, I don't have any VCLT because I'm such a new channel and I'm still just building it and not a lot of people know me, so I don't have any VCLT to show. So I'm NA on number 18. So I'm jumping to number 19, album with no writing on the jacket. I went with Bob Dylan's Blonde on Blonde. I realized that there's some the Columbia label there on the stereo, but other than that, there is no writing on this jacket. There's the other side. And yeah, I thought, yeah, I think Blonde on Blonde, you know, suits that question. I wanted to show, because I do believe, yep, the original. Again, 2i Columbia, so I'm very happy to have found this. It's an American pressing, and it's an original Blonde on Blonde for no writing on the cover. Love it. Okay.
Where are we now?
Oh, yeah. So number 20 is a 7-inch single. I don't have a lot of 7-inch singles. In fact, I think I only have 3. So I went with this one, The Beatles, The Long and Winding Road, $6.75 there on the old price tag. Now that must have been a used price. I didn't pay, somebody gave this to me, which is really nice of them. It's an original. For You Blue is the flip side of that. It's obviously a US, I don't know, 1700 Broadway. So this is gonna be a US pressing. Oops, sorry about my little alert there on the computer. But anyway, yeah, The Long and Winding Road, 7-inch single. Yeah, so you believe that I do have the single in there. There's the 4-year boo-boo. And Long and Winding Road. All right. There's the 7-inch single. Number 21, show a colored vinyl album.
Okay. And this could have been for the
Show New Wave record too, but Devo, Are We Not Men, from August of 1978. Paid heavy on that. I'm not exactly sure why I paid $40 for that. But anyway, I did. Are We Not Men, Devo. And it's on this really interesting, I'll take it out here. It's on this really interesting, really pretty, kind of almost like a tie-dyed, kind of a tie-dyed purpley green gray color, but it's great record and fabulous. And I believe this is from 78 as well, this colored vinyl. But anyway, Devo, Are We Not Men, from a colored vinyl entry. Now the last question, show an album from 1982. And I was thinking about all the, I have a lot from the early 80s, but I thought I'd go with this one. Pete Townsend's All the Best Cowboys Have Chinese Eyes. It's one of those Townsend records that, look what I got it for too. Are you kidding me? What does that say? $2.99? Fantastic, and it's great. That makes up for the $40 Devo record, a little bit anyways. This is a fantastic record. I never realized how good this was. I picked this up about, I don't know, maybe 6 years ago, and I had no idea how good it was, and I really, really like this. I have a good buddy, a very close friend that is a huge Who fan, a big Townsend fan, and he never talked to me about this record, and then when I got it, I talked to him about it, and he said, oh yeah, it's one of my favorite solo records by Pete. Anyway, that's my entry for the vinyl tag 2022. Thanks to Rob Walker for putting the list together. Good time putting it together, and yeah, I'll let Rob know I don't need to. It's not a contest video. What an idiot I am. Anyway, this is my vinyl tag 2022 entry. Thanks, everyone. Talk soon.